Greetings everyone, you are welcome here. In this video, I am going to talk about KMap and how we can reduce SOP Boolean expression using KMap. Now, what is a KMap? A KMap is a graphical representation of truth table which is useful for reducing or minimizing Boolean expression. Although we can reduce Boolean expression using algebraic reduction method, but Boolean expressions, they can be more quickly and easily reduced with the help of KMap. Steps to reduce Boolean expression using KMap. So the first step is to draw a KMap. Step number 2, plot KMap. Step number 3, group the terms in minimum number of groups. Step number 4, read the reduced expression from KMap. Now let us see how to draw a KMap. A K-map is a collection of squares where each square represents one min term in case of SOP expression. There can be three types of K-maps, two variable, three variable, four variable, and in this video we will talk about these maps only. Now let us see how two variable K-map looks like. In a two variable K-map, there will be four squares and the diagram for two variables A and B will look like this. You can see there are four squares. Now the first variable is A and then we have written B. For A, we will first write 0 and then 1. And this is referred to as A bar and this is referred to as A. Similarly, for B variable, first we will write 0 and then 1. So 0 refers to B bar and 1 refers to B. These are the corresponding min terms of each cell. And if you look at the truth table of two variables A and B, each min term of the truth table corresponds to the term in the K-map also. So you can see this is A bar B bar, the second one is A bar B, the third one is A B bar, and the last one is A B. Now let us look at a three variable K-map. In a three variable K-map, there will be 8 squares, and this is the truth table for three variable K-map. And the truth table, each min term of the truth table should correspond to the K-map. So the cells are numbered like this. We have written like it, written like this, A, B, C. So if we have first written A, that is A bar, and 1 for A. While numbering these cells, let us look at the order. Very important to note. This is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0. So this binary code is usually called gray code. And in this, each successive number differs only in one place. We can see we are changing only one term from direct to complement form or from complement to direct form. So here we are changing C. See, only one change is there. Here we are changing B from this term to this term. And from this term to this term, we are changing only term C. So this is referred to as B bar C bar. This is B bar C, BC and BC bar. So if you look at the intersection of these two, so this one becomes A bar B bar C bar, this is A bar B bar C and so on. And the midterms are numbered as M0, M1, this is M2 and then M3, this is M4, M5 and then last one is M6 and this one is M7. So look at the position of the midterms very carefully, because if you place them wrongly, your K-map will become wrong. If you are drawing your K-map like this, you are putting AB here and C here. So it will look like this. You have 0, 0 again, 0, 1, 1, 1 and 1, 0. And for C, you will first place 0 and then you will place 1. And the position of min terms will be M0, M1, M2, M3 and then first here M4, M5 and then we go up M6, M7. Now let us discuss a 4 variable K-map. A 4 variable K-map, there will be 16 squares and if there are 4 variables A, B, C, D, your maps will look like this, and this is the truth table of 4 variables, and all the min terms, they must correspond to the min terms of the K-map. This is very important, they must correspond to each of them. So if you are placing AB here and CD here, so this will again become 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1 and 1, 0. And again this side 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1 and 1, 0. So I have already told you this is called a gray code if you place the binary codes like this. And in which only one term is changing from direct to complement or from complement to direct. So this will become A bar B, AB, AB bar. And similarly, this will become C bar D, CD and then CD bar. So we look at the min terms. This is M0, M1, M2 this side and then M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. This is M8, M9, M10, M11 and this is M12, M13, M14 and this one is M15. And if you are drawing it like this, you are putting CD here and AB here. And look at the placement of min terms. This is M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7, M8, M9, M10, M11, M12, M13, M14 and then M15. So please look at the position of the min terms. If you don't place them properly and correctly, your K-map will go wrong. Now the step number 2 is plotting the expression in the K-map. Now to plot the expression, first the expression should be in canonical SOP form, very important. And then for every min term which is present in the Boolean expression, mark 1 in the corresponding cell of the K-map. Let us consider we have an expression of 3 variables A, B and C. An expression is A bar B bar C plus A B bar C plus A B C bar plus A B C. So let us plot this expression on the K-map. So the first one is A bar B bar C. So we look for this. A bar is this and this is B bar C. So at the intersection of this, this is the cell. So we'll put 1 here. Then the next is A B bar C. So you can see A and this is B bar C. At the intersection of both these, we get this as the cell. We'll place 1 here. Then A B C bar. So this is A and this is B C bar. So at the intersection of this and this, this is the cell. So we will put 1 here. And the last one is ABC. So this is A and this is BC. So we put like intersection of this, we will get this as the cell and we will place 1. The other method of plotting is that you can draw the truth table and find the minterm numbers. And then accordingly, you can place 1 after finding the minterm numbers. So that is also a correct method. Now step number 3, grouping the minterms. So there are several rules of grouping. Please see each one of them one by one. So, rule number 1 is a group must contain 1, 2, 4, 8, 16 and so on cell. That is in the power of 2. A group of 2 cells is called pair, 4 cells is called quad and 8 cells is called octet and so on. So, if this is the K-map which is already drawn and plotted, so we can have group of 2 ones and we cannot have group of 3 ones. This is wrong. Rule number 2 is that groups can be horizontal or vertical, but they cannot be diagonal. So, can see in this K-map, one group is vertical and one group is horizontal. So, this is correct. But in this K-map, we have placed them diagonally. So, this one is wrong. Group number 3, groups can overlap. So, you can see in this K-map, these are the two groups and these groups are overlapping. This one is present in both the groups. So, this is correct. But if we draw it like this, if we group it like this, so this one is wrong because this will not give the minimized expression. Groups should not contain any cell containing 0, should not include any cell containing 0. So after plotting 1, the cells which are left, they can be marked as zeros. But while grouping, we should not include any cell which contains 0. So this is wrong and this is right. In every group, at least one 1 should be unpaired. Very important rule, rule number 5. The group in which no 1 is unpaired is called a redundant group and it should be removed. So we look at here, this is okay, this K-map. But if we look at this, in this there are 3 pairs. In this first pair, this one is exclusively for this group. And this one is paired with this group also. If we look at this yellow group, in this there are 2 ones. This one is exclusively for this yellow group. And this one is paired with red group also. But if we look at the red group, in both the ones which are present in red groups, they are paired with other groups also. So this one is paired with orange group and this one is paired with yellow group also. So this group is redundant because in this group, there is no one which is exclusively present for this group only. So we must remove this type of groups. Rule number 6. Group maximum number of 1s in minimum number of groups. Very important to note. In a 3 variable K-map, always look for quads first. And if quads are not present, then look for pair. And in a 4 variable K-map, always look for octet first. If octets are not present, then look for quads. And if quads are not present, then look for pair. So you must remember this rule. So if we have a K-map like this, in which 4 ones are present, then we must pair them, we must group them in quad instead of grouping them in pairs. So this will go wrong. We must have quad if 4 groups are present. And similarly, for 4 variable, we must, if there are 8 ones are present at adjacent positions, we must group them in octet. Otherwise, we will not get the minimized expression. Rule number 7. Groups may wrap around the table. Very important to note. The leftmost cell in a row may be grouped with rightmost cell, and top cell in a column may be grouped with bottom cells. Cells in 4 corners of the map, they are also considered as adjacent and they can be grouped. So, we look at this K-map. There are 2 groups which are present on the left side and the right side. So, instead of making pairs of these 2 groups, we can always make a quad of it. This will give us the minimized expression. If we roll the paper, they will come adjacent to each other. So, we can make a quad instead of making a pair. Similarly, if we have top cells, we have, see, you can have all, we have ones in all the top cells and all the bottom cells. So instead of making quads, this time we must make an octet, because this is a 4 variable K-map. So this is the right expression and this is the wrong grouping. Rule number 7. Cells in 4 corners of the map, they are also considered as adjacent and they can be grouped as quadrant. So you can see this is the, they are present in 4 corners of the cell. So we must make quad instead of grouping them separately like this. Now, step number 4, writing the reduced expression. So there are 2 rules for writing. The first one is, each group corresponds to 1 product term from K-map. So, and the rule number 2, the term is determined by finding the common literals in that group. The literals or variables which are present in both the forms, that is normal or complement, they must be omitted from the resultant product term. Now let us look at few examples of writing the reduced expression. Suppose we have a 3 variable K-map with 1 plotted like this and grouped like this. So if you look at this blue group, which is a vertical group, so if we look horizontally, so we have both A bar and A belong to this group, and if you look at vertically, B bar and C is present. So in this group, A bar and A both are present, so this will be removed and we will get the min term as, we will get the term as B bar C, the expression, the product term as B bar C. Now if you look at this horizontal group, here you have A this side horizontally, and vertically you takes B bar C and BC as the variables. So A is okay, but if we look at these 2 terms, B is present in both the forms, B bar and B. So B will be omitted. So we have A and C as the product term for this group. So the final expression is B bar C plus AC. If you look at this 4 variable K-map, so we have one quad, one octet here. So if you look at this octet horizontally, we have A bar, B bar, and here we have A, B bar. So we A is present in both the forms, so A will be omitted from the product term and we have only B bar. And if we look at vertically, it contains all the variables C and D in all the forms, complement as well as direct. See, all of them are covered, so they will be omitted from the expression and we get only B bar as the product term. And this is the only term, because this is the only, this is the mapping, so this is the only term and this is the minimized expression for this particular K map. So we finally look at the gist of this. We see in a 3 variable K-map, group of 2 terms will have 2 Boolean variables. You can see if this is a group of for pair, we have 2 Boolean variables. And if we make a group of 4 terms, we will get only 1 Boolean variable. And if you look at a 4 variable K-map, group of 2 terms, that is pair, we will get 3 Boolean variable. Group of 4 terms, that is octet, we will get 2 Boolean variables. And group of 8 terms, that is octet, we will get 1 Boolean variable. So in this example, this is an octet. So for an octet, we have got only 1 Boolean variable. So if you remember something like this, you will never make mistake. So let us do few examples from previous year's board question papers. So this question has been taken from the Outside Delhi paper 2017. So this is a 4 variable K-map, U, V, W, Z. And these are the minterm numbers which we have to plot on the map. So we will first draw a map, draw it very carefully. I have drawn it in both the manners. You can draw it any one of the manner which you like. So first I have placed UV this side and ZW this side. So my minterm position numbers are M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7, M8, M9, M10, M11, M12, M13, M14 and M15. But if I place ZW here and UV here, my minterm numbers will fall like this: M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7, M8, M9, M10, M11, M12, M13, M14 and M15. Once you have drawn it correctly, the next step is to plot ones for each minterm. So I have plotted like this. See, you can see the position of all the ones for each minterm which is present here. I am plotting one in the K-map. The next step is to group them. So I have already told you, in a 8 variable K-map, always look for octet first, as no 8 ones are adjacent. So we'll look for quads. Now one quad we can make like this. These 4 ones are adjacent. Then one we can make like this. Two top and two bottom ones. We wrap them around. They will become adjacent. And we can make one quad like this also. But if you look at this quad, in this quad, no one is present which is exclusively for this quad. You can see these two ones are already paired with this blue quad, and these two ones are already paired with this red quad. So if we make this quad, this will become a redundant group. So I've already removed this group. Similarly, in this case, I make two quads, one this and one this, and one pair. And here also I have made one pair. So again, I can make this quad also, but I am not making this quad because this is a redundant group, and in this group no one is present exclusively for this particular quad, as all the ones are already paired with other groups. So now the next step is to write the reduced expression. So if you look at this horizontally, you have UV and UV bar. As V is present in both the forms, so V will be omitted. And if you look at vertically, you have Z bar W bar and Z bar W. Again, W is present in both the forms, so W will be omitted. So the final product term will be U Z bar. If you look at this group, in this group horizontally we have U bar V bar and U V bar. As U is present in both the forms, so U will be omitted and we will put V bar. And vertically we have Z W and Z W bar. As W is present in both the forms, so W will be omitted and we have only Z. So final product term for this quad is V bar Z. Now we look at this pair. See, we have U bar V bar and U bar V. As V is present in both the forms, we have only U bar. And if we look at vertically, we have Z W bar only for this pair. So the final product term will be U bar Z W bar. And similarly, we get from this K-map also, this is the final expression. And for all the product terms, we will sum them so that we can get the reduced SOP expression. So look at the marking scheme. You have half mark for drawing the K-map with correct variable names. It is very important. Variable name should be correct, whatever is given in the question. And half mark for plotting the ones correctly. Then half mark for three groupings. There are three groups. And half mark for writing the final expression in reduced or minimal form. And very important to note that half mark will be deducted if you use wrong variable names. So instead of U, V, W, Z, if you use X, Y, Z, W or A, B, C, D, so half mark will be deducted. And half mark will be deducted if any redundant group is present. So if you make this group, this is a redundant group, so half mark will be deducted. Let us look at another example. This question has been taken from Outside Delhi paper 2016. So now, the expression is, you have four variables PQRS. So again, very careful, take PQRS as the variable names, don't take any other variable name. And then this is the minterm numbers. So I've drawn the K-map again, and again it is drawn in both the manners, whichever manner you like, and but remember to place the minterms correctly. Then plot one for each minterm which is present in the question. So we have already plotted. Then we are doing the grouping. Again, in this, again, no 8 ones are present adjacent, so octet is not possible. So we'll go for quads. So one this quad, this, then one horizontal quad, all these 4 ones are adjacent. Then I'm making one quad, like, because all these 4 ones are adjacent. And again, instead of making pair, make quads, maximum of quads, because these 4 ones are also adjacent. And in this quad, this one is exclusively for this quad, you can see. Although these ones are paired with other groups also, this one is not paired with any other group. So this quad is possible. Similarly, in this quad, this one is exclusively for this quad. Although this one is already paired with red and these two are already paired with purple, but this one is exclusively for this brown quad. So this is also possible. Similarly, I have grouped the ones here. So while writing the final expression, this is my final expression for this quad. Again, P and Q are present in all the forms, so they will be ruled out. And we have R bar, S bar. For this quad, we see vertically R and S are present in both the forms, so they will be omitted. And we have PQ bar only. For this quad, you can see P is present in both the forms, so this will be omitted. We have Q, and vertically R bar and S is present in both the forms, so we have only S will be omitted. So we have Q and R bar. And for this quad, again Q is present in both the forms, so Q will be omitted. We have P, and if we see vertically, R is present in both the forms, so R will be omitted, and we have P S. Then we look at the marking scheme. Half mark for drawing the K-map with correct variable names. Very important. Half mark for each of the four groups. These are the groups. And half mark for writing the final expression. And half mark will be deducted if you write wrong variable names. So please remember to use the right variable names. And one more question from Delhi paper 2015. Again, in this question, we have four variables X, Y, Z, W. And these are the minterm numbers. So again, draw the K-map carefully first. And for all the minterms which are present, plot the ones in the K-map. These are two forms. You can draw whatever you like. There's no need to draw both of them. Then again, look for octet first. No octets are present. But this is the quad which is present. Again, these two ones can also make a quad. And these two ones can make pair. These two one again can make a pair. And this one cannot be paired with any. There's no adjacent one. So this will be a single one. We cannot make pair or quad with this one. So this will remain single. So simplified expression will be, if you look at this pair, this will be if you look at this first quad, so this is X, Y bar, and vertically Z and W are present in all the forms, so Z, W will be cancelled out, and we have X, Y bar. If you look at this quad, we have X will be ruled out because X is present in both the forms, and Y bar, and we look at vertically, this is Z bar W bar and Z bar W, so W will be cancelled out, and we have Y bar Z bar. So this is the term Y bar Z bar. Now if we look at this, we have X and Y, X Y bar, so Y will be cancelled out, and vertically Z bar W bar, so this becomes X Z bar W bar. And for this pair, we have X Y and X Y bar horizontally. So Y will be cancelled out, and vertically Z W. This will become X Z W. And as this one is not paired, or this is not grouped with any of the other ones, as it is present, no one is present adjacent to this one. So this is a single one. And for this, we will write the product term as X bar Y and vertically Z W bar. So this will become X bar Y Z W bar. So half mark for all the five grouping, for each of the five groupings, and one mark for the writing the final reduced expression. And half mark will be deducted if wrong variable names are used. So be careful while writing the correct variable names and drawing the K-map, and then plotting and grouping. So if you like this video, kindly give thumbs up, and please subscribe to my YouTube channel. It is Learning Simplified. Thank you.